grace of our Lord Jesus Christ to be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Yeah, can you stand up for a minute, please? Can you stretch your hands? There is a prayer which is taught by Jesus Christ, our Father who art in heaven.
No, wait.
Jesus did not pray this prayer in English because he was not born in England. He prayed this prayer in Aramaic language. So I'm going to say this prayer in Aramaic. Do you like to listen in Aramaic?
Yes.
Stretch your hands, please. Abuvun didushmayo natkadesham teti malkuto nakhve sabiyano. I can know doshmayo af ara hablan lakhmati sukana yomona vashbukhlan haubayin. I can know dofnana shabakana lahaubayin. Wala chalala nasiyono illa pachaman bisha. Matul dilakhi wa malkuta wa haila wa tishbukhta la alam almin. All together, please say a little louder. Amen.
Amen.
Little more louder, please. Amen.
Amen.
Little more louder, please. Amen.
Amen.
Whenever I say, Oh Jesus, please say Amen. Little louder. Oh Jesus.
Amen.
We surrender this two-day convention unto your mighty hand, Oh Jesus.
Amen.
We surrender your servant Mario Joseph unto your mighty hand, Oh Jesus.
Amen.
Control his thoughts, words and action, O Jesus.
Amen.
We surrender our life unto your mighty hand, O Jesus.
Amen.
Send the word of healing and deliverance, O Jesus.
Amen.
Send the word of wisdom and knowledge, O Jesus.
Amen.
Send the word which delivers us from all problems, O Jesus.
Amen.
Rabbi Srahli Sodiri Vayasarli Amdi Vahlalukadatam Melisani Yafkahu Kauli, O Jesus.
Amen.
O Jesus,
Amen.
Give us long life and good health on earth, O Jesus.
Amen.
Protect us from all contagious major ailments and disease, O Jesus.
Amen.
Protect us from financial crisis, O Jesus.
Amen.
Protect us from road accident, O Jesus.
Amen.
Protect us from natural calamity, O Jesus.
Amen.
Protect us from family and social violence, O Jesus.
Amen.
ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Join your hands, please. Remember Holy Mother. Remember your guardian angels. Remember your patron saints. Shalom lakum aryam malatah ke sadadona imek barukat banashim mubaruk parbatna ki yeshua maryam hakedo shayam haya lohim hitpale liba adanu hakochim hata uvishet motenu. All together say louder, Amen.
Amen.
Please repeat this prayer after me. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
O my guardian angels.
O my guardian angels.
O my patron saints.
O my patron saints.
Turn right and left and say, Peace be with you each other. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Can you lift your both hands, please? Turn right and left. If somebody not lifting the hand, please hold that hand and lift it up. Can you wave your hands like this, please? Little fast. I said fast. You all are affected with the jaundice or what? Doing like this, do it fast. But be careful of your wedding ring, okay? Okay. Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? No? No? No, loud! Stop. You're clapping for me or clapping for Jesus? You give bad things to Jesus, good things to Jesus. But your clap was very bad clap. You're clapping for Jesus. That should be very good clap. Okay. Once again, all together, give a loud clap to Jesus. Stop. Anga paru or Ayanavaram clap eppadina. One gentleman there loudly clapping, looking at me. Sir, if you clap like that, I will not get anything. Even Jesus will not get anything. But if you clap maximum louder, there will be pain for your hands and your blood circulates on your brain and heart, cut, 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 and you will be energized to listen class. And dear sisters and young girls, a beauty tip for you. If you clap louder, the blood circulates on your face, it is equal to golden facial massage. One clap, 5,000 savings. So when you're clapping, that should be maximum loud. Okay, one second, all together, give a loud clap. No. Loud. Okay. Can you lift your both hands and say louder, hallelujah. Little more louder, please. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm. Little more louder, please. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Fan is there, it directly hit your ear. So I was saying just to keep little behind, okay? There is no secret, don't worry. When one or two gather in my name, I will be there, said by Jesus. So definitely Jesus is here, because more than two gathered here. Do you believe that Jesus is here?
Yes.
So I will say hello Jesus, expecting you to say one hi Jesus little louder. Hello Jesus.
Hi Jesus.
Little louder please. Hello Jesus. Jesus is in me, Jesus is in you, Jesus is in us all. Do you believe that?
Yes.
Turn right and left and look at the eye of someone and say, hi Jesus, please.
Hi.
Some people,
hi Jesus.
Smile and say, hi Jesus, okay. Very good. Come back to subject. If a Muslim met another Muslim, first what he will say? Assalamu alaikum. Can I have the reply from you? Wa alaikum assalam. Assalamu alaikum means peace be with you. Wa alaikum assalam means also be with you. If a Hindu met another Hindu, greeting should be Om Shantihi, which means peace be with you. And if a Jew met another Jew, his greeting should be Shalom Lachem, which means peace be to you. So the world major religion, Hindus greeting peace be with you, Judaic greeting peace be with you, Islamic greeting peace be with you. And what is the Christian greeting? Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. For whom it is good, for you or for me? Nobody is in good mood. And somebody says, praise the Lord. That also is wrong. That is only Pentecost people, not Catholics. Praise the Lord, Stotram. What should be our greeting? Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19. After the resurrection, when Jesus met his disciples, first he said, peace be with you. Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 27. Before going to heaven, Jesus said, I give you my peace. Gospel of Luke, chapter 2. This house. My brothers and sisters, please understand, if we met someone, greeting should be peace be with you. When you are going away, we should say, let us go, peace. And once if you go to a house, you must say, peace be upon this house. But I have never seen any Christians practicing this. If you meet anyone, you will never say peace be with you, because you don't have peace, then how can you give? When you are going, you will never say, let us go with peace. You will say bye-bye only. You will never go with peace, because if you leave someone behind, you will go and meet third person and backbite the first person. After my talk, you will go out and you will say, Mario is too cruel. Now I am looking very tired, but after some time I will become cruel. Wait and see. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Now, we have never gone to a house saying, peace be upon this house. Because we go to a house not to bring peace, but to destroy the peace which is existing in that house. If we go there, peace is lost. So all those who are attending this Divine Mercy 2 days convention, the beginning, first session, please understand, 3 Bible words. Greeting should be, peace be with you. Answer should be, also be with you. But I personally say, don't say in English. Hindus says in Sanskrit, Muslims says in Arabic, Jews says in Hebrew, you must say in Aramaic, because Jesus spoke Aramaic. And I will teach you that, not in the Syrian Aramaic language, because it is difficult for you to learn. It is Shlomo Lekulkun and Valru Hodilok. It's difficult for you to learn. So I will teach you in Hebrew Aramaic, very simple. All together repeat after me, Shalom.
Shalom.
Please repeat louder, Shalom.
Shalom.
What is the meaning of Shalom?
Peace.
That you know. Next word, Aleichem. Aleichem. Which means, be with you. Aleichem. So, Shalom Aleichem, peace be with you. Okay, all together repeat after me, Shalom Aleichem. And the reply should be, Aleichem Shalom. All together say louder. Little more louder, please. This should be our greeting hereafter. If you meet someone, Shalom Aleichem, then they must say, Aleichem Shalom. So your WhatsApp status update should be, Shalom Aleichem. Your Facebook status update should be, Shalom Aleichem. If you pick up the phone of your mama, first you must say, Mama will tell, morning you were normal, what happened to you now? I am attending convention in Ayanavaram, Mama. Now, after this convention, Monday when you meet your colleague in market or anywhere, you say, Shalom Aleichem. He will ask you, what is that? You can evangelize just with this question. You can explain. The Christian greeting is so and so. Hello, Jesus. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
So now turn right and left and give shake hand to your neighbor and say Shalom Aleichem. Please give shake hand and say. Chalega. One aunty giving shake hand and saying, peace begins with smile. Because smiling is positive, contagious disease. It is highly contagious. If you look at someone and keep 2 teeth out, they will keep 4 teeth out. That is smiling. It is always contagious, okay? Don't be very serious. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Now, this convention is known as Divine Mercy Convention. Say louder, what convention? So, the first talk of today is completely on Divine Mercy and it's very, very deep class. Only if you attend properly, you will understand. Suppose if I understand that you are not understanding, I will make you to understand by irritating you. So it is better you try to understand very easily. Okay? Are you with me?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
This class will go for 2 hours almost. And in between, no permission to go for this. If you want to go, I also will go. And in between, if you want to stand up for a few seconds, you please tell me, I will make you to stand up. Choir is there, they will sing also. If you want to drink little water in between, you ask me, I will give you my water. I am very good in sharing water bottle, okay? I believe you all will have. But no disturbance, please make sure. That's all I want to say. So let me begin the class. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Why did I begin the class by in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit? Usually Mass only begins with that. Why? Please write down the word. Colossians chapter 3 verses 17. Colossians chapter 3 verses 17. Bible says, when you do anything in your thoughts or in your words or in your action, do it In the name of the Father, Son and of the Holy Spirit. I didn't say Bible. When you do anything, so when you are drinking water, in the name of the Father, Son and of the Holy Spirit, let me drink. When you keep the key in the car, in the name of the Father, Son and of the Holy Spirit, let me drive. When you want to calculate your account, in the name of the Father, Son and of the Holy Spirit, let me calculate. When you want to make a call to someone, in the name of the Father, Son and of the Holy Spirit. If you keep doing this for anything which originates in your thought or in your word or in your action, that particular things will be holy and that will never bring any harm to you. I didn't say Bible, huh? Somebody can read that in your Bible. So let everybody listen that. Colossians 3:17. Who will read? And whatever you do, word or deeds, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, the Father Almighty. Correct? In the name of Jesus you must do, giving glory to Father. When you do anything in action, words, and in some translation, the thoughts also is mentioned. Which is that one? RSV or Good News, which you read? RSV. Okay. Hello, Jesus. Little more louder, please. Hello, Jesus. That's why I said, let us begin the class in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Okay? So this class is going to be very holy for you and very heart-touching for me too, for all of us. As you all know that I was born Muslim, and then first time when I was in Pota, after 3 months of my conversion, Father Augustine Valluran asked me to share my testimony on stage. I went to stage, I don't know much of Bible, so I began to preach about Jesus from the Quran and my experience. After a few minutes of preaching, I asked people to lift their both hands and say loudly, Hallelujah. They all lift their hand and they were saying loudly, Hallelujah. Then I began to look around, is there any lazy person not saying Hallelujah? Hello, Jesus. George, say, Hello, Jesus. While I was looking around, who is not saying Hallelujah, I saw one lady from the crowd stood and running to stage. When I looked at her, I thought she is Muslim coming to beat me. I was very afraid. I threw my mic to her hand and I ran away. Literally, I ran away from the stage because I don't want to get beaten from that Muslim lady. But when I went out of the stage, I heard she is preaching. You know what she preached? My name is Fatima Rabello. I came from Goa 4 years before there was an accident for me. Due to the accident, my both legs were paralyzed. I could not stand and walk last 4 years. I came here by ambulance, came to hold by wheelchair. That's my wheelchair and he's my son who brought me here. But when all of you said loudly, Hallelujah, without my knowledge, I stood up. Now I can see my both legs are functioning very well. Loud one. Good. She was jumping, dancing and screaming and the people were shouting. I actually ran away with fear. But when I heard her testimony, I became little proudy. I thought I am good speaker. My first preaching, paralyzed got healing. So my second preaching, the dead people will come out. A kind of proud for me, I am good preacher. In that pride, I came back to stage. After coming back, I don't know Bible, so I took Quran and preached. What I preached, Holy Quran, chapter 3, verses 49. The Holy Book of Muslims, Quran, chapter 3, verses 49. وَأُبْرِعُ لَكُمَ هَوَى الْأَبْرَصَ وَأُخِيِ الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ Allah says, Jesus cured born blind, leukodrome man, leprosy man. Quran says Jesus healed blind, leprosy, leukodrome. And the balance Quran says that same Jesus is alive even today. He healed the sick and he's still alive. So, after preaching these things from the Quran, Almost 1 hour I spoke again. When I went out of retreat hall, all the retreatants came and surrounded me. They thought me and God is very close. If I say anything, God does. They thought we both have some secret relationship. And by chance it happened, no, I don't know anything. When they surrounded one auntie, one old lady came in the crowd, hold my hand and began to beat her forehead. Pray for me, brother. Pray for me, brother. She's beating her head with my hand. I was really puzzled. I don't know what to do. Really, because I don't know. I'm only 3 month old Catholic. Nothing. In that shivering, I said one lie. I said, I must go for pee. Then they give the way and I went to my room. Locked the room and lie down. People were waiting, thinking that I will come back after my pee. 1 hour they waited, I didn't come back, so they went to retreat hall. But one gentleman was in search of me and he came to my room and he knocked the door. I don't know who I opened. When I opened, an elderly man looking in front of me, you know, he said, not yet finished? I said, I have headache, I'm sorry. He's not going. I said, why are you waiting? Please pray for me, brother. I said, God bless you. He looked at me saying, that's not enough. I said, then what else you need? Counsel me, brother, counsel me. I don't know what is counseling. I am only 3 month old Catholic. Again, my ego began to work. If I say, I don't know what is counseling, it is shame for me. It is better to give him counseling. I sat and I gave him one chair and I asked him to sit. I hold my Bible in my lap. You know why I did this much? In Porta, I have seen counselors are doing this way. I don't know what to pray, but I heard our charismatic counselors praying the same way I prayed. I don't know meaning. What these people do, I also did the same. After a few minutes of I touched him and said, tell me your problem. Then he looked at me with a lot of respect, asking, did you get any vision, brother? I said, vision after some time I will get. Now you tell me your problem. Then he began to cry. Like a small baby, the tears was coming out. In the tears, he shared what happened for him in his childhood, his parents, brother, sister, wife, children, all. When I heard all his problem, my heart became very soft, absolute, because first time I am hearing that much painful story, and first time I am seeing an elderly man look like my dad crying like a small baby. I could not bear his suffering. Slowly, my tears also started flowing. After some time, I am not answering. That man wiped his tears. When he looked at me, I am crying. He slowly stood and came to me and started making lullaby, saying, no problem, brother. You don't worry. I will pray for you. My counselee became my counselor. My counselee became my... That was my first counseling experience. So I am here with you 2 days, don't come for counseling. Finally, you will learn to become counselor, okay? Be careful. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Little more louder. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
That night I could not sleep even 1 minute. Early morning I went to chapel and I kneeled down between altar and tabernacle. I kneeled down in this gap. And I said, Jesus, I believe that you are my God, but you are not good God. You may be God, you may be powerful, you may be almighty, no doubt, but your character is not good. You know why I said? Jesus, if you are a good God, you would have not put me in shame. When I preached, there was a paralyzed lady, she got healing, and people thought that I have the charism. They came to me and they put me in shame. If you are true God, give me power to heal the sick. That's all my demand. Give me power. You know what was his answer? I did not give you any power and I will not give you any power. For you it is smiling, but for me it was heartbreaking. I screamed loudly. Said, Jesus, if you did not give me any power, how that Fatima Rabello, the one who was paralyzed 4 years, stood and walked? When I ask, you know what was his answer again? My son Mario, you never knew that there was a lady called Fatima. You never knew that she was paralyzed and you never prayed for her, isn't it? I said, yes, Lord. Then how can you say that you healed her? You never knew that there was a paralyzed lady in the crowd. How can you say that you healed? My inner self was walking. I understood, true, it's not me. I humbled myself and asked, Jesus, tell me then what happened. You know what was his answer? My son, I have called you and I have anointed you to go and preach my word. You went to stage with the same anointing which I give you, you preached word. And that word touched that Fatima, one who was paralyzed 4 years, and that word healed her. It's not you. Louder, please. Thank you. From that very moment till today, it is 21 years over. From that day till today, my duty is to go and preach. Balance, God does. And these 2 days also, I will stand here and preach the word. I will not preach anything from my pocket. From the word of God, from the written Bible. And definitely, that will work in your life. And tomorrow evening, you will have many testimony to share. It's not because of Mario. It's not because of Pota. It's not because he has some charism. Sorry. What charism I have, you two have. Because you took baptism, I took baptism. And you received Jesus' body, I received Jesus' body. You received eternal life, I received eternal life. What you don't have, I don't have. What I have, you have. And if somebody teach you that you don't have charism, only they have charism, they are cheaters. You may not understand what I am saying now until I finish this class. But the fact is that. So I don't have anything to give you new, but I will share the word of God, and the word of God will give you something. Word of God is not only to discuss, that is to activate. It activates in your life. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Can you lift your both hands? And wave your hands like this, little fast. If somebody is sleepy, beat on their head. Tap! Sorry, 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 I have. That's it. Very good. Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? That's not enough. Loud clap. Very good. Can you lift your both hands and say louder, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Please, once again louder, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Now, few verses from Bible, please write down. Wisdom 16:12. Somebody can read, please. Wisdom 16:12. If you are not reading, I will read. For
no
neither
medicine,
the herb... who is reading? Yeah.
No medicine or ointment cured them. They were restored to health by your word.
Yeah.
Oh Lord.
Enough. Now two things I am going to tell you here. No medicines, no doctor can cure you. But God sends his word to cure you. Very important. We have an understanding that medicines can cure us. Do you think that medicines can cure you? See, according to medical science, medicines never eliminated any disease till today. Not even a single disease. But medicines are the result which is creating new disease every day. All the new ailments and disease are the result of your own medical science. When you created vaccination for chickenpox, it became HIV. When you are trying to find out vaccination for HIV, the Zika virus is already. When you take paracetamol for headache, you think headache is gone. No, headache turned into kidney stone. That's it. Or headache turns into cholesterol, sugar, pressure, anything. Medical science changes one disease into another form. And sometimes it becomes more dangerous than the previous form. So the medicines cannot cure all disease. I repeat, all disease. So you agree with me, please. So there is no point of Apollo or any Apollo. Next, doctors cannot cure you. Do you think that doctors can cure you? Andy, if the doctor can cure you, why the eye specialist coming to check your eye with big glass on his head? The doctors are coming with big glass checking your eye. First, let him cure himself and come back to check my eye. No doctors can cure you. You go to Apollo, some of the cancer specialist doctors, they are already cancer patient. And they are checking you, saying, guarantee I will heal you. Very bad. You are wrong. So you understood these things. Medicines cannot cure all disease. Doctors cannot cure all disease. But my word, not Mario's, his. He says, my word will heal any disease and anyone. Hello, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Next, Psalm 107 verses 20. Psalms 107 verses 20. No one to read? Who read it? Once again, sister, I was busy drinking water. Yeah, next sentence you read. And deliver them from their destructions. Hello, listen. God says, I will send my word to deliver you from your destructions. Say louder, from your? Please say louder, from your? What are your destructions? What are your destructions? Please tell me. What is your destruction? Spirit is destroyed, huh? Sin, no? You don't know what is your destruction. Let me tell you. The air which you are inhaling now is polluted. That is destruction for you because of the vehicles and the factories. The water you drink is polluted because of the factories and wastage on the earth. Yes or no? And the fruits which you eat is destroyed because of pesticides and medicines and medications, injections, powder. So the entire nature is destroyed. Altogether, say louder, the entire nature is? And you are destroyed because of accident, because of war, because of cancer, because of AIDS, because of Zika, because of chikungunya, because of many, many other things. And you are destroyed because you have some problem in your family and you have financial problem, you have mental disorder and you are sleepless, you have lot of allergies, your children are disobedient. Your brothers and sisters are drunkards and alcoholics or, you know, drug addicts or womanizers or prostitutes. Or disobedient children not studying well, no house, and you know you have many, many kind of destructions. Can you agree with me? Say yes or no. Yes. Especially in Chennai city, we have many, many destructions. And God did not say, hello Chennai people, I will send an appa or amma to deliver you from your destructions. Or God did not say, oh Chennai people, I will send Narendra Modi in India to deliver you from your destructions. No. God did not say, I will send Ronald Trump to United States to deliver you from your problem. He did not say. Because he knows that these people can make your problem into more worst situation. Why? The politicians, you must know, with the nuclear weapons which is available only in US, if the Donald Trump press one button from White House, 150 planets like Earth can be burned within a minute. That kind of nuclear weapons only in US. Amma, one button, the Earth is not there, only ashes. Not only Earth, 150 planets like Earth will be ashes. That kind of nuclear weapons only in US. And what about China, Korea, Japan, India? If you trust these politicians, be careful, you are standing on the top of a nuclear bomb. That's it. That's why God said, I will not send these people, because they will make you to sit under bomb. Our country, India, you think it is poor country, but you know how many crores of rupees every month we are spending for defense ministry, for the navy, military and air force, for the recommendation food and weapons and trainings and vehicles and petrol and AC and etc. How many crores every day? And in the same country, you know how many lakhs and crores are dying because starvation, no food, malnutrition? Same country you are spending to create weapon and dying people. Do you think that this country can save you? No! Not only this, any country in that matter. Somebody supporting me so much. Thank you so much, no boy. I love you. He understood Mario Joseph very fast. Hello, Jesus. Can I have it a little more louder? Hello, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? No, I said loud. Loud. Yeah, thank you. So no point of trusting politicians. Next. You thought your technology and science can save you from your problems. But finally, the technology which you developed can find out the child in the womb, male or female. If it is female, will make it juice and put it in closet. That is the progress of your own technology. Creating your own destruction by your own technology. Seriously. So no hope even in technology. Now then you thought maybe the religious people will save you. Who are the religious people? That may be fathers or ustads or sannyasis or purohit or whatever it may be. But what they are doing, traveling all over the world, collecting crores of rupees, coming to their own respective place, building big, big masjid, temple, gurudwara, church. And they are proud to say that my church tiling is this many crore and my masjid tiling is this many crore and my temple tiling is this many crore. They are proud to say that, and surrounding that masjid and temple and church, hundreds and thousands dying because of starvation, malnutrition, no medication, no education, no house. No point of trusting these people also. Oi! He supported me. The Chotawala. Oh, yay! Correct. You people are simply sitting, he is understanding and answering. Hello, Jesus. Now, one thing I know, that you have many, many problems in your life. And for that problem, the medicines cannot solve the problem, doctors cannot solve the problem, technology cannot solve the problem, politicians cannot solve the problem, religious people also cannot solve the problem. That's why God said, I will send my word to deliver you from all your distractions. So the hope comes back to the word of God.
Anna, na adicha thanga matta moonu maasam thoonga matta modi porru veetu poi seramatta தூங்குறதுக்கு கோவிலில் வந்தவரா நீங்க? சுற்றுவேன் துப்பாக்கி.
All of you are listening and one gentleman there.
Hello, Jesus. Still out of place. Hello, Jesus. And two words I taught you now, the third one, Isaiah 55, 4 and 5. Sorry, Isaiah 55, 10 and 11. Isaiah 55 verses 10 and 11. One minute, somebody reading from behind, please. And one who is with a mic, please read.
Water the earth. Hmm. They make the crops grow and provide seed for sowing the food to eat. Hmm. So also will be the word that I speak. Hmm. It will not fail to do what I plan for it. Hmm. It will do everything I send it to do. Hmm. You will leave Babylon with joy.
Wait. Snow and rain comes from the sky. Yes or no?
Yes.
Once it waters the earth, earth produces eatable things for you, wheat or rice, you know, whatever it may be. Then the water will go back as evaporate. Now the waters are going up as evaporate after producing all things for you. After the pongal, it's going back. Hello, Jesus. And God says, so shall my word. When I open my mouth, the word comes out. And it does some work in the life of human being. After completing my intention, that word will come back. Without completing, the word will not come back. You know what I want to say? God tells you, my brother and sister, these 2 days you will listen to the word of God, and the word which comes to you will never go back without doing the intended duty in your life. And what are the intended duty? Saving you from your destruction, healing you from ailments and deliverance. Hello, Jesus. Where are you? Hi, Jesus. Healing you from ailments and disease and delivering you from your problems. What are the problems and what are the ailments and what are the disease? You don't know. After learning that, the medicine will come to you. Okay? I want you to do one action and read one word with me from Bible. That is Proverbs chapter 4 verses 20 to 24. Only write down, no need to read now. I will read and please repeat after me. All of you keep your left hand like this, please. Left hand like this, like a beggar. Andy, don't worry, I am also like a beggar. See, look at my hand also. Don't worry, everybody like a beggar. And right hand like this, like Fidel Castro. All of you. And then repeat after me. My son. Please louder. My son. No. With anger and with the love. Maximum louder.
My son.
Look at my word.
Touch my word.
Read my word.
Hear my word.
Memorize my word.
That word is
medicine for you.
Life for you.
Wave your hand and say louder. Life for you. Some people are not doing any action. Everyone must do action. Suppose if you have any disease ailments for your hands, you are going to get healing right now. So you must do action. Once again, all together. And maximum louder. My son.
Look at my word.
Touch my word.
Read my word.
Hear my word.
Memorize my word.
That word is
medicine for you.
Life for you.
Life for you.
உன்ன நான் தூக்கி கேரளாவுக்கு போயிடுவேன். ரொம்ப பிடிச்சிருக்கு. முகம் ஒன்று பார்க்கணும்னா ஹாய், நைஸ், வெரி குட், ஹாய். கேன் யூ லிஃப்ட் யூர் போத் ஹேண்ட் அண்ட் சே லவுடா ஹாலேலூயா. லிட்டில் மோர் லவுடா ஹாலேலூயா.
Bible is a medical shop. All together say aloud, a Bible is a
medical shop.
Every verses in Bible are medicines. Every words, 35,000 verses are there, 35,000 medicines are there. Why this 37,000 medicines? Because you may have 37,000 problem. For each problem, one medicine. But you don't know what is your problem, and you don't know which is a medicine, and you don't know how to eat the medicine, but you are owner of the medical shop called Bible. Everybody is holding Bible in their lap, but they don't know how to operate and what are the medicines, how to eat, when to eat, why to eat, nothing. This is the problem of the Catholic Church and the problem of the human beings generally. Problem of the Christians particularly. You don't know how to use this medical shop. Divine Mercy Convention, I am going to teach you how to use this properly. Do you want to know that?
Yes.
No. Only 2-3 aunties and uncles, yes, balance all. No. Do you want to know this?
Yes.
That should be the answer always. Okay. What is your problem? First question, what is your problem? And how many problems you have? You have given, that's why no problem. If you do not give, how many problem you have? How many?
So many.
Oh, he has so many problem, but he kept the problem in someone else's hand. Very intelligent man. All his problem given to wife and he sits quietly. Hey, you do everything here. Do you have any problem in your life? How many?
Unlimited.
Unlimited problematic women, unlimited problematic man. We have both now. Do you have any problem?
Yes, I have.
How many?
A lot of problems.
Lot. What about you? Many? Many, many problems. So I understood one thing. Ayanavaram is the place called problem place. Because everybody have many problem. Nobody without any problem. Hello, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
One day I ask God, God, how many problems you give to human being? I should know how many. When I ask, you know what God said? That we read in a book called the Book of Job. Book of Job, chapter 5, verses 19. Somebody can read. Book of Job, chapter 5, verses 19. Okay. Read chapter 5 verses 19.
Yeah. Time after time, he will save you from harm. When famine comes, he will keep you alive, and in war, protect you.
Which
from
is that
death.
Bible?
Good news.
Good news. No. Any other Bible, please? Okay. One minute. Give this mic to her.
He will deliver you from 6 troubles. In 7, no harm shall touch you.
Good news also Catholic Bible, RSV also Catholic Bible. See the difference between the translation of Christian Bible. That one has no meaning of this, this one has no meaning of that. The number 6 is not there even. Very sad. This is a problem with Christian Bible translation. All this began with Protestant groups and poor Catholics are suffering. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
A little louder, please. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Job says that God will deliver you from your 6 problems. Say louder, how many?
6.
You said you have unlimited problem. You are grandmother of Job. I never knew that Job is from Ayanavaram. And his brothers, sisters, parents are all here. I never knew that. Many problematic people.
Let both be on, Ayya. When I go out, I will put off. Don't worry. Okay. That may be the seventh problem. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Little louder, please. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
So Job says that God will deliver you from six problems. You know, Job is the one who suffered maximum on earth. And his suffering was only six. So yours will be only five, not six. If you have six, you are equal to Job. So, Ayanavaram people, if somebody asks you how many problems you have, less than six. If you say more than six, you are insulting Job. And let me count six problems. And I will show you, most of you will have at least one, and some will have two, three, four, five. Very few will have six. I'm not saying there is no one with six. Eh? But you cannot show a person with seven problems. If you show a person with seven problems, I will write down my property in that man's name. It's an open challenge. Because the word of God will never make mistake. Andy and uncle will make mistake. They will have many problems, countless problems, unlimited. But God will never make that. So let me count all six problems. You know, my brothers and sisters, God created this universe within 6 days. Say louder, within?
6 days.
Please say louder, within?
6 days.
Creations are the problem. Say louder, who are the problem? How many days creation? So how many days problem? 7th day, no problem. Sleeping day. Resting day. So, I'm going to teach you 7 problems. When I make mistake, please correct. Only these youngsters corrected me. The elderly people, yeah, 7 problems. Yeah. I will make mistake purposefully and unknowingly also. But it is your duty to correct me. Problem number one. Problem in your society. Problem in your society. Problem between husband and wife. No. Problem with your neighbors and you. I'm talking about society. For example, you stay in an apartment and somebody in that apartment is jealous of you. And your boss is jealous of you and your colleague is blocking your promotion. And when you get good mark, someone is jealous of you. When you buy a good car, someone is jealous of you. When you sing very well, someone is jealous of you. You sing very well and when you stand near the mic, that girl pulls the mic up. Let my voice come out. I'm not joking. This is what happens. Simple thing. See that girl, you know what she did? She slowly came and turned the fan towards her. Have you noticed that? That is the social problem. Baba, I'm just joking, okay? For them to understand what I'm saying. That's all. Hello, Jesus. She just opposite. She did not turn towards her. She turned towards the big bosses who are sitting near the instruments, you know. But this is what our life, problem between each other. How many of you know that somebody is torturing you and troubling you, backbiting, murmuring, spoil your name, blocking some business and sales and, you know, doing mantravada, what you call the black magic on you. How many of you know that somebody is troubling you and you need deliverance from them? If you really know that and if you need deliverance in this retreat, put up your right hand. If you know that somebody is troubling you and you need deliverance, put up your right hand. Wave that hand. Maybe 30% of this group lifted hand, 30%. Balance how many percent? 70%. Sitting like this, looking at me. Brother, nobody is troubling me in my society. But I am the one troubling everyone in my society. You're fooling Mario Joseph. Don't say lie. If you are human being, someone will have problem with you or you will have problem with someone. Definitely. I am Brother Mario now, 22 years is getting. You know what is my problem? One day I took one man to preach and he came with me and he preached very well, better than me. Every routines appreciated him, clapped for him and went to meet him. Nobody came to me. From that day till today, I did not took him with me to preach. And I will never take him also. Jealousy. I have this jealousy. And you say you don't have? All those who 70% sitting like this, you know, when they are driving their bike, scooty, if a Mercedes-Benz man comes in front in a wrong way, what all bad words this man will say? தள்ள தந்த கார் வாங்கி கொடுத்திருப்ப அகங்கார திமிரம் வந்த வர பாத்தியா ஏய் பிரதர் எனக்கு யாரிடம் சண்டை இல்லை பிரதர்னா பாவம் புனித சொல்ல சொல்ல எழு விட்டு திருநீவோ யூ ஸ்பீக்கிங் லை ஐதர் யூ ஹாவ் ப்ராப்ளம் வித் சம்மன் ஓர் சம்மன் வில் ஹாவ் ப்ராப்ளம் வித் யூ Parish priest will have a problem with assistant parish priest will have them with a problem with the committee members, and committee members will have the problem with the choir group, and choir group will have the problem with sacristy, sacristy will have the problem with Mario. Everywhere problem. And these people say, no problem, brother, no problem, brother. No. Please be honest to you and tell me, how many of you know that someone is unhappy with you or you are unhappy with someone? Any side. If you know that any problem in your life, put up your right hand. See, first you were liars, now you spoke truth. Okay? Speak truth throughout this day. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Little more loud. I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Little more loud. I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
How many problems I said?
Six.
But how many I explained?
One.
Which is that? Problem in your society. Problem number two. Problem in your family. Husband and wife like snake and mongoose. Why are you laughing? Snake and mongoose are very good. They fight always. But when over rain and when there is water flood, both will climb upon one tree to save themselves. Both will climb in same tree and sit on same branch also, no fighting. You see husband and wife fighting so much, you try to go to solve the issue, they will come together and you will be out and finally they will blame you. How many family I involved to solve the problem, finally I became their enemy. Nowadays I try to keep away from family. If you solve, you will be in trouble. Mongoose and snake, that kind, okay? Fighting, but they come together. Not only between husband and wife. Some husbands, when he see his mother-in-law's shadow, he gets fever. And father-in-law's name, his BP gone high. Cannot accept in-laws. Or some people, no in-laws, no husband-wife problem. Problem with own siblings, brothers, sisters, for property matter, or for education matter, or for parents' love matter. Father loves only him, not me. Only her, not me. Everything for her, then who am I? Very sad news. My wife, from first standards till 10th standards, studied in a school, and 10 years there was another friend with her, like how these children. And immediately after my marriage, my wife took me to her house, Rajini, she's Hindu, and introduced. They were very close friends. And they married before my wife got married, means we got married. And their child, the first one is in 10th standard. Second one is in 7th standard. The 10th standard child looks like mother. Mother is very pretty looking. This Rajin is very pretty looking. And husband, father is very not that African type. So, I'm sorry to say, The second child is like daddy. So daddy begins to love the second one. Mama began to love the first one. Wherever mama goes, take only the first one. Wherever daddy goes, take only the second one. So there was a kind of slight discrimination. I was feeling that. Many times I told both of them, be careful. You know what happened? Day before yesterday, morning there was an argument in the family. Father said, I will educate only my child. The one who finished 10th standard, your child, you find out the way. Mother cried and mother went to parish priest and spoke. Parish priest said, I cannot educate your children, let him do. Child heard that, came back home. Her mother picked up the call to call a friend and share the things, what is happening in the family. Meanwhile, mother heard some noise, went into the room, she already committed suicide. 10th standard girl. Very pretty looking girl. The problem is with dad. Of course, half is with mom also. Dividing children. Papa's son, mama's boy. You don't understand what will happen in the family. Children will lose their life. Huh? Very, very bad characteristics. Yesterday was the funeral. My wife could not go and she's still crying because we were in another place for convention. Yesterday, early morning, 2 o'clock, I reached home. 4 o'clock, I left home. That's how I'm here now. I didn't sleep even one minute yesterday night. Morning, of course, in the plane, I slept 1 hour. Sitting sleep. I never knew how I got in train and I never knew how I came out because half drowsy I was. Even when I came to stage also, I was little drowsy. I don't know whether you noticed. Now I'm okay. I'm awake. Don't worry because you made me awake. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? Loud clap. Loud one. Can you lift your both hands and say louder, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Little more louder, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
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 So second problem in your family life. So how many of you know that someone in your family is unhappy with you or you are unhappy with someone? If you have this problem and if you really need deliverance in this 2-day convention, put up your right hand. If you have problem in your family, wave your hand. Everybody lifted hand. So in Ayanavaram, no social problem, only family problem. But one gentleman, you see how he's looking at me? You know what he says? Brother, it is better when you ask to lift the hand. Otherwise, you will make me a liar and finally you will make me to lift the hand. So whatever you ask, I will lift the hand. Very good. Third problem. Financial problem, lack of vitamin M. You don't understand vitamin M? Money, lack of vitamin M. How many of you, please be honest, how many of you really need deliverance in your financial area? Wait a hand. Okay. Very many of you, put down your hands. So how many problems I said now? Huh? 3 4 3 Total how many are there? How many over? Balance how many? Fourth one is physical problem. Ailments in your body. Disease in your body. How many of you have any sickness in your body? If you have any sickness, put up your right hand. Wave that hand. Oh. Almost everyone, do hands down. Hello, Jesus. And the fifth, mental problem, crack people. How many of you have crack? If you are really crack and mentally ill, put up your right hand. Five people there and 3 people here. Put your hands down. 5 plus 3, 8 people are mentally cracked in this church. At the time of lunch break, be careful. Don't walk nearby them because the situation is very critical. And team leaders, be careful, okay? Only 8 people lift the hand and balance were sitting like this, looking at me. But according to psychology, if anyone is affected mentally, that man will never admit that he is mental. According to psychology, if anyone admits that he is mental, which means he doesn't have any mental problem. So 8 people, those who lift a hand, has no mental problem. And all those who were sitting like this are already affected with mental disorder situation. Let me check who are mental, this 8 or you. Some of you have fear of anything in your life, fear of cockroach. Amma, cockroach! Amma, listen! Snake! Blood! Some of you have some fear, darkness, blood, or you know, dog, or cat, or lizard, or cockroach. Do you have any fear in your life? If you have any fear, put up your right hand. Wave the hand. Everyone lift the hand saying that you have fear. Fear is the beginning stage of mental disorder. Now you tell me who are mental. We are mental. Degree is less. That's the only difference. Hello, Jesus. Hi, Jesus. Somebody sent me a WhatsApp message. It was a very funny message. One man went to a psychiatrist and said, "Doctor, I'd love to know how to check the mental patient, how to know whether this man is mental or no." Doctor said, "Fetch the water in washing machine and give a spoon and bucket and ask him to empty the washing machine." Then this man said, "Oh, if he is mental, he will go with the spoon to throw the water out, isn't it? So he will be mental." "I will never do that, sir. I will take the bucket and throw the water out." The doctor said, "Your seat is reserved. Please occupy room number 19. "Why, doctor? I am not mental." "No, man, you are mental. If you are normal, you would have opened the drainage pipe of the washing machine to empty washing machine. Are you with me?" And this is how we all are mental. Usually. Really. That's why we call not charismatic but crackmatic. Little. We should be. So, at least let me tell you, you all have some tension, some fear, some worry, and some guilt feeling, some anger, some jealousy, some sadness, some problem in your mind. Yes or no? How many of you get some tension very often? If you get any tensions, please put up your right hand. Wave your hand. Which means all of you are mental. Okay. Total how many problems I said? 6. Spiritual problem. Spiritual problem means no self-control. Thinking not to drink alcohol but drinking. Thinking not to smoke but smoking. Thinking to listen this class but sleepy. See that sister sleepy? She want to listen class but she sleepy, so she is doing. I think this problem everybody has, so no point of asking you to lift the hand. Everyone has this problem. Thinking to go for mass but you are unable to come out of a cheat. Very often. Thinking not to watch porn movie but very often. Thinking not to do any sin but you are doing. It's not you but the sin which is dwelling in you is doing. I didn't say, Saint Paul said. Hello, Jesus. Now let me ask you something. I am robbed. I robbed your mobile. I robbed. So you call me robber. Yes or no? So you call Mario robber because he robbed. Yes or no?
Yes.
No. That is wrong concept. Because Mario robbed, do you call Mario robber? You are wrong. I become robber not because of robbery. I was a robber, that's why I did robbery. You didn't understand. அப்பறஞ்சது தாண்டா கரெக்ட்னு சொல்லியச்சு அவன். இப்ப நீ சொன்னது தாண்டா கரெக்ட். By robbing, I am not becoming robber. Because I am robber, I am robbing. That is correct. Because I am liar, I am lying. It's not because I lied, I became liar. No, I am already liar, that's why I am lying. I am already robber, that's why I am robbing. That's why St. Paul says, I am thinking to do good, but I am unable to. I am thinking I don't want to do bad, but I am doing it. It is not I, but the sin which is dwelling in me. I am already a sinner from the womb of my mom. I am a sinner. I am sinning. Because I am sinner, I am sinning. I did not become sinner after committing sin. I am sinner, that's why I am sinning. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Let me ask you something. Are you following me clearly?
Yes.
Do you feel boring because I am preaching like this?
No.
I know very serious preaching also. If I preach seriously, you will be double serious. You know how you will be serious?
Yes, sir. Completely true, sir.
What time you will stop, sir?
But if I preach like that, you will not feel boring and you will understand. I will not preach many things. I will preach little things, but that little things you must understand.
Some will preach many things and you don't understand anything. That's not a good way, little, but understand. So this many you understood very well. Six problems. Say louder, how many problems? Is there anyone among you without any of this problem? No one. Is there anyone among you with seventh problem? Tell me the seventh problematic man. Andy, unlimited problem, Andy. Where is the seventh one? Cheto, Chetanele paranya, the Enya tira the person and the Yeramata the carnage and patinilla letter. Kobarna, Kitasanka, to Konganu let alone? Na? They were saying many problem, countless problem. I counted 6th, 7th one they don't have. Then why did they say unlimited? Only 7. Now let me ask you. When you go to a medical shop, a very huge medical shop, how many varieties of medicines you will see, you will find there? Say louder. Many. Do you know one thing? 2 weeks before, when I was in Mumbai Zion conducting a convention, there was a medical doctor, a senior medical doctor, specialized in many subjects. That doctor came and asked me this question. How many medicines will be in a medical shop? I said, it is up to the medical shop owner. He said, a medical shop, all the medicines on earth are available. How many medicines will be? 1 lakh? I said, maybe, may not be. At least 1,000? I said, that can be definitely. Then he smiled at me saying that, so far the medical science created only 23 varieties of medicine, not 24. Huh? I said, if that is the case, then why so many medicines? Doctor smiled and said, same company, no. Same medicine, but different company. Paracetamol in by 10 companies or 20 companies, 100 companies. Different name. But the content is same. Are you with me?
Yes.
After saying that, doctor said, I thought of telling you because you were explaining only 6 problems and people were not happy to understand that. So I thought, brother, you go and preach this also. Medical science has only 23 medicines. If that is the case, Bible, what Bible says is absolutely true. Only 6. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Can you stand up for a minute? All of you stand up for a minute. Choir, do you have any good song where people can clap and sing? No? They must clap very well. You don't put any melody or song to put them to sleep once again.
Great and mighty is the Lord our God. song that I sing. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. Lift up the banners, let the anthem rise. To Christ our King. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is He. He's setting me free. His Holy Ghost power. He's setting me free. This very heart. He's flooding my soul. He's making me whole. He's setting me goes by. Thy loving kindness is better than life. Thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall praise Thee. Thus will Thy bless Thee. Thy loving kindness is better.
Thank you so much. Nice song. Some people are missing. Washroom is so far. Lift up your both hands and say aloud,
Hallelujah.
Once again, all together, maximum louder, Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? Say loud one. Okay. Please be seated. I think Reverend Fathers are sitting behind the church for the confession, to hear confession. If anyone really wants to make confession, go and confess your sin. I thought confession will be tomorrow. So this afternoon I'll be preparing for that. So it's up to you. You can go and have confession meanwhile, if anybody wants to make. Okay. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus. Little louder, please.
I love you, Jesus.
Now you understood six problems. Why did this problem and how this problem comes up in your life and in my life? There are so many scientists who came to find out why the problem on earth. Gautam Buddha, Mahavira, Guru Nanak, Shirdi, Baba, Kali, Muruga, Baswana, Vamana, Ayyappa, Allah, Muhammad, Jesus.
All the gods and goddesses and prophets and etc., they came to earth to find out why the human beings are suffering and how can they eliminate suffering from your life. And in their excavation, they have understood so many things, and that was written in their thesis work called Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvana Veda, Purana, Itihasa, Talmud, Upanishad, Tripitaka, Abhidhamma Pitaka, Upanishad, Bible, Gita. Every religious books on earth have been written to teach you why you are suffering and how can they eliminate your suffering. That's why if you go to a Muslim masjid, imam will tell you why you are suffering and how can you be saved. If you go to a Christian church, the priest will tell you why you are suffering and how can you be saved. If you go to a Hindu temple, the pujari will tell you why you are suffering and how can you be saved. Every god and goddesses and religion originated on earth to teach you why you are suffering and how can you solve your problems. But when I read the entire religious scriptures on earth, when I did my MA in religion and philosophy from Madurai Kamaraj University, I studied all the religion, and when I read all religion and all religious scripture, I understood one thing. The only religious book which could really diagnose the problem of human being and which could really provide the medicine for the solution of the human being's problem is Holy Bible. There is no other book which could diagnose your problem, which could give the medicine for your problems. Can you lift your both hands and say louder, Hallelujah. Can you say a little more louder? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Now let us check what the Bible says and what Quran says, what Gita says, all religious scriptures. Very, very important. I need your attention. Let me begin from Quran because I was born in Islamic family. وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ أُولَئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلَّ فِينًا طَيِّبًا زُرُورًا. Hope you understood. Then what you're listening on? God Allah says in the holy book Quran, I have created every creature on earth to obey me, and every living creature obeys me, except man whom I created in my own image and likeness. Hello, Jesus. Every creature on earth obeys God except man. And the balance. They have been created to lead a holy life, but they lost it. They became like animal, and they became worse than animal. Balkum alal, but more worse than animal, Allah says. When I was in Arabic college, I was very angry. I stood and said, teacher, which means Allah says that I am worse than dog? Teacher said, yes. I was very angry. How can God call me dog and worse than dog? I don't like this God, I said. Teacher said, can you stand for a minute, Baba? I stood. This is important, eh? My son, have you ever seen any male dog marrying another male dog? I said, no. But Baba, men are doing that. Who is better, dog or man? I said, dog. Next. Baba, have you seen any female dog marrying another female dog? I said, no. Women are doing it. Who is better? I said, dog. Next. Baba, have you seen any female dog going to gynecologist to abort the baby from the womb? I said, no. Women are doing it. Who is better? I said, dog. Last one. Baba, have you seen any male dog drinking alcohol before going to sleep with his wife? I said, no. men are doing it. Baba, who is good? I said, teacher, Allah said the fact, dogs are better. I said, you are laughing, but this is a fact. This is the fact. Where is that animal? Balance. Man have been created to lead a holy life. They comes down into the level of animal, from the animal even lower than animal. Allah says, that is why the entire nature is in problem. In the Holy Quran, there is a chapter called chapter Yunus. Yunus. Say aloud what? Yunus. You know who is Yunus? Jonah of Bible. Do you know who is Jonah? You don't know? The one who traveled by the whale without paying any ticket in air-conditioned bus, that also under the water. Great man. And God says his story in the book called Yunus, Jonah, the chapter called Jonah. He says, I called Jonah saying, Jonah, go to Nineveh to preach. He said, why should I go to Nineveh? I will go to Tarshish. He disobeyed. When he disobeyed, there was tsunami, Katrina, water flood, and cyclone. People throw him into sea. Yes or no? Now, Quran says, look at the sun. Sun. I said, sun, rise at the east, set at the west. Sun is doing till today. Yes or no? Suppose if the sun disobeys and rise at the west and set at the east, what will happen? Okay, suppose if sun disobeys and take 1 week holidays today, what will happen? No darkness, you will be frozen within 24 hours, you will be ice. The entire India will be Himalaya. 24 hours is enough without sun. Okay, now 12:30, sun in the middle. Suppose if sun wants to come down 1 inch to see what is happening in Ayanavaram church, what will happen for you? Burning, you will be nowhere, ashes. 1 inch, now only burned already. Now you want 1 inch to come down and complete. So the sun obeys God from the moment of creation till today. Yes or no? Say yes or no.
Yes.
One galaxy did some disobedience and there was some tsunami. Small disobedience, over. God wants to teach you. If any of his creation disobeys, what will happen to this universe? And from the day of birth till today, you are only disobeying. Only disobeying. How many times I said, don't go out. People are still going out and coming, going out and coming. They think it is mother-in-law's house. Go on, come, go on, come. Disobedience. Even after disobeying this many times, you are still alive. Oh, miracle. You have only 6 problems even after disobeying. You would have get 1 crore of problem. Thank God only 6. So Quran says, you are suffering today because you disobeyed God. The nature is in trouble with you and you are in trouble with nature. Can you lift your both hands and say maximum louder, hallelujah. No, once again, maximum louder, hallelujah.
Sarvadharman parityajya mamegam sharanam vraja aham tvam surga pabebhyo moksha ikshami mashuja karmanyevadhikaraste mafalesu kada jana మా కర్మ ఫలకే దుర్బోర్మాదే సంఘోస్త కర్మణే.
దిస్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ ది గీతా చాప్టర్ 8 వర్సెస్ 13 to 15, శ్లోక నంబర్ 13, 14, 15.
Arjuna went to Krishna saying, Krishna, I have committed so many sin. I want to confess my sin. Let me confess, will you forgive me? You know what was Krishna's answer? Arjuna, I give you freedom to choose your karma, but not to choose the consequences of karma. That is compulsory either in this life or in next life. All were stuck. You are not stuck because you don't understand what I say. I'll give you example, then you will understand. Parable. Arjuna, I give you freedom to choose your karma, which means what you want, you do. You have freedom. If you want to commit adultery, do. You have freedom. If you don't want to, don't do. You have freedom. I will not involve. You have freedom. Balance. But if you do adultery, there is a consequences. That is HIV. You don't have freedom to choose it. That is compulsory, either in this life or in next life. If you commit adultery, HIV is compulsory, either in this life or in next life. So in this life, you saved because you were very precocious. But your next birth will be for HIV parents. You are innocent, but you will be born in HIV blood. I didn't say Gita. If you eat salt, you will be thirsty. If you commit sin, you will get the punishment, either in this life or in next life. I didn't say, Gita said. Quran says you disobeyed God, you are suffering. Gita says you disobeyed God, you are suffering. So what Gita says, what Quran says, ekdam same. Disobeying God is the reason for the problem here on earth. Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? No, I said louder. Louder. Very good. Now what the Bible says? What the Bible says? God created Adam and Eve in paradise and he said, enjoy everything. But don't touch this fruit. If you touch this fruit, the day you eat, you shall die. The day you eat, you shall die. Say louder. Please say louder. Did they eat the fruit? No. Yes or no? I'll tell you how they ate. You come here. And then you come. Who is, you come then, the first one. They are asking who to come. Come. I am Adam. You are Eve. Come. Now, she came to the fruit. Okay? Look at the fruit. And tell me something. You know what she says? To Adam, she says, Adam, God said not to eat it. Yeah? I said, yes. She says, you don't eat, but look what a beautiful and pretty looking that flower. She says, so I looked. Wow, beautiful. You are much beautiful than this flower. Now again she says, not to eat, but no problem in touching or plucking it out. Let us pluck it out. I climbed the tree and plucked it out. Then Eve says, God said not to eat it. He did not say not to smell it. Smell and see how tasty. Wow. Ah, super. Hugo Boss. Then she says, Daddy said not to eat it. He did not say not to taste it. Shall we taste it? Little drop will make mighty ocean. Are you with me?
Yes.
Sit. Thank you. You know how the Satan comes to this camera operating man? Satan will come and ask, Baba, God said not to commit adultery. He did not say not to look at that pretty girl, go and look. God said not to commit adultery. He did not say not to give shake hand, give one shake hand. God said not to commit adultery. God did not say not to get WhatsApp number. Are you with me? Little drop will make mighty. Siruthulli. Very well known. That's why Saint Paul says, don't give chance for devil. Say louder, don't give chance for? I will show you if you give chance for devil, what will happen. Stand up. Come. Come with me. Sit. This is whose chair now? What's your name?
Princey.
Look like Princey only. Princey. Sit properly, Princey. How old are you, Princey?
Nine.
My second daughter, your age. Abhya. Look like Abhya only. My children missing me a lot because now vacation I am not at home. Only those time, what to do? Okay. Now anyway, Princey, I was standing here more than 1.5 hours now. 1 hour 45 minutes. So little back pain for me. I want to sit. But I don't want you to get out and go. Give me little place to sit. Oof. Princey, how many brother and sister you have?
Only one child for my mother.
Only one child for your mother. You are lucky one. I will bring 2-3 cane and give to your mama. Because if there is only one, beating should be 7 times double than the 3 children. Anyway, Princey, my left leg also is paining. Give me a little more, please. Don't give place for Satan. When I ask you first only give me a little place, you would have said, get out, Satan. You give me a little place, now you don't have place. What to do now? What to do now? You want to push me? Then push. No, Baba, I will tell you, you cannot push me out because I am more powerful than you now. What you can do, you can tell Jesus, Jesus, this chair was mine, someone else is sitting there, please take him out. If you say that, Jesus will come and push me, then I will go. Are you with me? Yeah, now go and sit. Take your chair also. Oof. Hello, Jesus.
Hi, Jesus.
When an evil thought comes to you, you have to abort that thought immediately. James 1:15. The letter to James, letter of James, chapter 1, verses 15 or 17. It says, when an evil thought conceives, it brings forth the death. So the bad thought comes to you, you have to abort that thought. If you keep that thought, tomorrow that will become sin. You met a girl, suddenly, immediately abort the thought. If you keep that her, next day you will stand the same place where you met yesterday. And that relationship become very close, that will lead you into sin. Anyway, Adam and Eve ate the fruit. Bible says, the day you eat, you shall die. Did they die immediately? Say yes or no.
No.
Please say louder, yes or no.
No.
You are not worthy to be called as Christians if you say no. Soul died. So no soul for you, akka? Enna akka pesuringa? Soula illama kovil vanditinga? Very, very important. You sing a song, dying, you restore our deaths. Rising, you restore our life. And if you sing that by your death, my death was destroyed, you are proving that you are dead. And you said you did not die. Adam did not die. Tell me whether they die or no. If they do not die, why Christ died? If they die, why you are still alive? Total confusion. See, look at this gentleman. Brother, Adam died or did not die? That is not my problem. I have some backache. Please tell me whether this will get healing or no. His problem is only backbone. But my problem is Adam. Hello, Jesus. Bible says 3 deaths. Say aloud, how many deaths? If you do not understand this, then there is no point of being a Christian, okay? There is no point of being a baptized Christian. So please understand this one. Write down the verses. First one, Genesis 2:17. The day you eat, you shall die. Death number one, Genesis 3:23. Genesis 3:23. Therefore, the Lord God sent him out from the Garden of Eden to work the ground from which he was taken. Adam, Eve, angels, God were in paradise. This is a paradise. And God said not to eat one fruit, and Adam ate it. So God sent him out of paradise. Now, Adam out of paradise. Hello, listen. Adam out of paradise. God in heaven. We lost the relationship with God. Completely lost. That's why you are in search of God. You are going to Rishikesh, Himachal, Arunachal, Ganga, Sabarimala, Guru Ayur, Palani, Velankanni, Lourdes, Fatima. Ippo Ayanavaram church lu kuda vanditta. To see whom? God. But nobody has seen God till today. Have you seen God anywhere? Say yes or no. You know, one day one gentleman came and said, brother, yesterday night Jesus came to my bedroom and spoke. I said, please write a letter to Pope Francis. Write a letter to Pope Francis saying that the second coming of Jesus is over in your bedroom last night. Sometimes these charismatic people fools us so much. Saying that they meet. It is lie. Nobody has seen God and nobody can see God until you go to heaven. Then what they are getting? They are getting only vision. Say aloud, only? Not reality. One day one man came and said, brother, in my first retreat I met Jesus. I said, I am in Porta 22 years, I did not meet, and you met within 7 days. How can you say that? Again lying. Only vision. So we lost the relationship with God. Amen. This morning when I landed in airport, I put on my mobile. Then I got an SMS from IDEA. Welcoming to Chennai. The same way, when God sent you out of paradise, he put a SIM card in you. Wherever you go, God can contact you. If you are in roaming, God will give you warning message. You are in roaming, be careful of using your mobile, otherwise you will have zero balance. Are you with me? Some people are laughing because they have been to roaming and they got the warning message and they ignored the warning message and now in zero balance. They are thinking 2 days to recharge from Ayanavaram Parish. You go to commit any sin, the message comes, don't do. Yes or no?
Yes.
Hello, Jesus.
Hi.
Do you agree that you have a SIM card? Do you have a SIM card?
Yes.
Now you came to Ayanavaram Church to dial. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Sorry, the subscriber which you're calling is out of coverage area. Please call after some time. You keep on dialing but not getting connected with God. Why? Either your SIM card has some problem or the tower has some problem. I think tower has no problem, only this mobile has some problem. This mobiles has problem. Not even for SIM card but the mobiles. So these 2 days, this is a workshop we are going to prepare. Not with the tools and nuts and bolts but with the word of God. Some inner changes. Hello, Jesus. Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? I said loud one. Loud one. Loud one. Okay, thank you. இங்க பின்னாடி உட்கார கூடியவங்க நான் வந்தப்ப கொஞ்சம் பயக்குது. என்ன தெரியுதா,
நான் அங்கே நின்ன இவங்க நல்லா தூங்கிட்டு இருந்தேன், வந்ததுனால பயம். என்னை தூங்கினவங்களை கழுத்தை நெருக்கி நான் தூக்கிலிட்டுருவேன். ஓகே, எதுவும் தூங்கக்கூடாது. ஹலோ ஜீசஸ்,
ஹாய்
ஜீசஸ். So we lost the relationship with God. That is called the first death. Second death. Please write down. 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 6. Those who live a sinful life are already dead. It is known as moral death. Altogether say aloud, what death? What is moral death? You are thinking not to drink, but you are drinking alcohol. Morally you are dead. You are thinking to do good, but you are unable to do it. Moral death. And Revelation 3:1 also you can write down. Revelation chapter 3 verses 1. And the third death, that is Matthew 22:41. To the left people God will say to go to hell. Hell is eternal death. Hell. That is eternal death. In Bible it called eternal damnation. Eternal destruction, whatever it may be. So three deaths. Lost the relationship with God, moral death, and eternal death. I will not. And the judge trying to find out a substitute to take this capital punishment. And who is that substitute? The judge's one and only son. Judge takes a decision. My son, all my children on earth, already I judge it, they are going to die eternally. Can you? Can you be a substitute? Can you bail? And son says, yes. There we find divine mercy. Hello, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Now we have died three deaths. Say loud, how many deaths? And these three deaths, Jesus dies on the cross. Please write down CCC 464. 4, 6, 4. The church confessed that the Jesus Christ is the true God and true man with two nature, a divine nature and human nature, not confused with each other, but united in the person of the Word. Therefore, in the humanity of Jesus, all things, his miracles, his suffering, and his death must be attributed to his divine person, which acts by means of his assumed human nature. Why Jesus is perfect man and perfect God? To save us. I didn't say. See. And then 2 Timothy 1:10. And which now has been manifested through the appearing of our Savior Christ Jesus, who abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Jesus abolished our death by his death. So what I am going to say, the death which destroys my death. First death, how Jesus destroyed, write down. First death, Luke 23:43. And he said to him, truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. Jesus, from the cross, looking at the right thief, he said, you will be with me in paradise. What was the first death? We lost the paradise. That was the first death. When Jesus died on the cross, he brought us back to paradise. And why you are not experiencing that? Afternoon I will explain to you. Very important class afternoon. Completely important. I don't want anybody to miss this. And the second death, 2 Corinthians 5:21. For our sake he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. Which means our moral death, Jesus died on the cross. All our sins he carried on the cross. And his righteousness he gave to us. We are righteous and he is sinner. Moral death also he destroyed by his death on the cross. And the third death,
John chapter 6 verses 51. Those who eat his body will never die but will receive eternal life. The third death was eternal damnation, eternal hell. That also destroyed in you by the body of Jesus. If you receive the body of Jesus in a worthy manner, if you drink the blood of Jesus in a worthy manner, that body and blood mingles in your body and blood, so your body and blood will never be put in eternal fire because the blood of Jesus in you. That's what Jesus says. Those who eat my body, those who drink my blood shall never die. Even if I die, I will rise them. So all three deaths have been destroyed by his death on the cross. That's why we sing, die, you restore our death. Rising, you restore our life. So many years you are singing without knowing the meaning. From today onwards when you sing, please remember the meaning. Are you ready for that? Can you lift your both hands? Lift your both hands. Wave the hand like this, little fast. I said fast. Fast. Kitne karche tu na fast karo na. Can you give a loud clap to Jesus? I said loud. Stop. All together. See, when I do like this one action, all together give one clap, tap, only one. Okay? Bursting this big crackers, only one. Okay? Only one, little more louder. Maximum louder. Where are these last crackers? Last one should be big one. Okay? என்ன பிரின்ஸ் இவர் எல்லாம் ஏமாந்து செய்யறான், சும்மா கை தட்டுறான். வெரி குட், தேங்க்யூ. ஹலோ ஜீசஸ், ஐ லவ் யூ ஜீசஸ். சிசிசி 1322 கேட்டகிசம் ஆஃப் தி கேத்தலிக் சர்ச் 1322, தி இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி யூகரிஸ்ட். And CCC 599, the death of Jesus on the cross you received through confession. CCC 651, the importance of his resurrection. Last, Gospel of John chapter 8 verses 32. You will know the truth and the truth will set you free. You will know the truth and the truth will set you free. Hello Jesus. Little louder. Hello Jesus. Now imagine this is a forest. Say louder, what is this? And here is an elephant, a wild elephant with trunk, wild elephant walking. Elephant. And our prince is very intelligent girl. You know what she did? She made a big pit here. And she put a small wood on the top of the pit and put mud. And the other side, sugar cane. Night, elephant coming, sugar cane. Water in the mouth, like how the princey gets when she sees raw mango. Children, you know raw mango? And elephant was very happy, walking, 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 walking. Fell down. Because there was a big pit. Do you know how the wild elephant is caught and made tamed elephant? This is the way. When the elephant fall in the pit, elephant become unconscious. After 24 hours, when the elephant came in conscience, elephant is in pit. And one mouth came. Ask elephant, if you lift the trunk, I will give you banana. Otherwise, beating. So slowly, banana. If you lift your leg, coconut. Otherwise, beating. So elephant, coconut. Wild elephant becomes tamed elephant. Hello, Jesus. Say louder, please. Hello, Jesus. One day this termed elephant thought, I am the slave of mouth. Say aloud, I am the slave of? Whatever mouth says, I must do. Otherwise, no food. So that's how this local elephant obeys mouth. One day, the local elephant was holding a wood and walking. Mouth was beating. Then original wild elephant saw that. A wild elephant came in front. Hello? Kya karega? Pagala kya? Krakwa? Aap elephant ho? Aap bada bada, tu bada elephant. You are big elephant. You are wild elephant. You have power and authority. Don't obey the mouth. Please lift your trunk, take him out, throw him out. He will reach America in 7 pieces without any visa or passport. Throw him out. But this wild elephant says, no, 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 I am slave. If I do not obey this mouth, I cannot get Kana. You get lost. I will suffer. Pulling wood. Suppose if the wild, if the termed elephant realized that he is wild elephant, he has the power to trouble the snakes and scorpions, you know what will happen? The normal elephant will take the trunk and will remove the mouth down and track, crushed off. Are you with me? Now you all are wild elephant created by God to be in paradise eternally. But the Satan made a pit and we fell down. And we became slave of mouth called Satan. Now whatever you do, you think if I please mouth, I can live. If I say lie, I can do business. If I say lie, I can be happy. If I earn money, I can be happy. Everything is mouth's idea. One day the real wild elephant Jesus came in front of you, in front of me, and said, don't worry, you are the children of God. I have given you authority, power to trouble on snakes and scorpions and tear the enemies and to come out. But still you say, no, I am slave, I am slave. If someone realizes this truth, you immediately will tear the devil and you will come out of the enemy. That's why Jesus said, one day you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. Truth is that you are wild elephant. The power, authority is already in you, but you are not aware. First, before eating food, you realize that already the Holy Spirit is in you, the power and authority in you, you can tear the devil out.
Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and mighty is the Lord our God. Great and